moving back to your time with Van Morrison, I mean, how did you find it? It must have played some incredibly large arenas and huge audiences. You know, what did you make of it at the time?
We didn't play that big of arenas. Van likes intimate sort of gigs. I think the most we would play would be 15,000 people.
Yeah, I know. Well, I'm sorry.
But I mean, like, you know, it's like nowadays, I mean, people play 70,000 and people like Steps and whatever, you know. And we did a 3-month tour once, and we used to do a venue that held maybe 10,000-15,000. Then at the end of the night, we'd go to a small little club at about 12 at night, and then we'd play again. We did a real low-key audience, and that's when he really took off. I think for Van, you know, Van's been doing it a long time, but he still, I think, he finds it very daunting to go out in front of
two huge
amount of people, and he's a very personal person.
He is a very personal person. I mean, there's rumour has it that he's actually a little bit grumpy. A grumpy person to sort of work with. What would you say to that? You know, this is only something I've heard kind of through the grapevine. Is that completely unfounded?
I think the press sort of work on that angle, because he won't do interviews. He used to have a band called Them, and in the beginning, when Them were big, he did loads of interviews. Then when he became quite big as a solo artist, again, he did loads of interviews. And after a while, he thought, well, what else is there to say? If they want to know anything about me, go to the archives, you know? I've said it all.
It must be quite frustrating being a musician, though. You write songs to share with other people, but also for yourself.
Yeah.
You're not selling the music for people to know about you. They want to know your music, so you must get a little bit sort of annoyed when you're constantly asked about your personal life. I mean, I can understand that. Yeah. When all you're interested in promoting is the actual music and the reason behind it.
Yeah. I was with Van about 4 or 5 weeks ago when he was in Portsmouth, and I spent the day with him at the hotel, and we're just talking about the old days and how we used to struggle and, you know, starve and really work hard to sort of try and, not to get anywhere for money, but to try to get somewhere, because it was a personal thing that you wanted your music to get somewhere.
Yeah.
In the 60s it was very much like that, and probably is the same today, you know. Kids get up there, they didn't think, oh, I'm going to get into this to make a lot of money. They get into it because they love it. You probably the same. You love to sing, you love to perform, you like, and I think then what happens, business takes over. And with Van, it was like a roller coaster. All of a sudden he went whoop, so high. And it became a big business. And a lot of that enthusiasm from when he was younger, when he was struggling to get his music across, you know, that dies. And now he said to me the other week, he said, I do a job. This is my work. My music is my work, it's a job, and that's what I'm paid to do. And my personal life and all my emotional things they're mine, you know. I'm doing a job, I'm going out, I'm performing, I do my job well. I mean, there's probably people out there who say, oh, I saw him and he was really grumpy, he really this. He's not, he's a very, very quiet person.
Yeah.
And very sort of quite subdued, believe it or not, but his whole thing is his music.
That's right.
His voice, his writing. And this is what he wants, I think. I've known him a long time. And I think he's trying to get across to people, listen to my music. Listen to my, you know, my lyrics. Forget me, you know, because I, you know, it's my music.
Yeah,
I want
that's
you to,
exactly
not,
right.
Not
that's
me as a person.
Exactly.
Not me as a,
now, you I mean, obviously, you're a musician, Herbert. You're a very good musician. You write your own songs also.
Yeah.
I'm dying for you to play us some more. Do play us some more tunes on your guitar. What would you like to play?
I'll do a slow one that I wrote. I wrote this song, a bit embarrassing for all these people out there who like Michael Ball. I mean, I've never really been...
Actually, I've only seen him sing once, and it was a Michael Ball version of Love Shack, and I'll tell you, it was interesting. Anyway.
Well, I wrote a song, and Michael Ball recorded it. I was very surprised, because I was never really a fan of Michael Ball's. But it was on one of his albums, and then it was on the best of Michael Ball.
Oh, okay.
There's a song like that, a slow song, but it's good. Don't give me mountains,
I can't come. Don't give me water. You could give me one. Don't give me the sun. If it doesn't shine, no. Give me love. You give me love, girl, don't you know? Don't give me the ocean. You know I can't swim. Don't play games with me. I could never win. Just to take it away. Give me love. You give me love, girl. Don't you know? You say you'll never love again. You tell me loving's caused you. It's caused you so much pain. But I said, come this way, and you'll see what I'll give to you. I'll give you love. I'll give you love. Give me sand, it slips through my fingertips. Why kiss my cheek? You could kiss my lips. Don't give me words that don't mean a thing. Give me love.